I was traveling a lot for a couple of months, last 2 months especially. I had been to Andamans for some time, then traveling to Maldives, then to Guangzhou, China, and I had been thinking of making a video related to my Andamans trip to a consolidated one. In fact, I had done daily vlogging when I was in Andaman, and I could cover almost 8 videos in that. Hope you have watched that. This video would be basically a summary of how to plan your trip to Andamans and what are the things you should be keeping in mind when you travel. All those things, sharing my experience. This is a video which I have made after traveling to Andaman, spending around 10 days there. So it would be a really informative video. If you are planning a trip to Andaman, please do watch this video till the end. I will divide this video into 4 parts. Basically, first one would be how to reach Andamans. Second part would be how to travel internally in Andamans. Third part would be the places that I would suggest you should visit. And the fourth part would be basically some trips and some important things that you should know before you travel to Andamans. Now, reaching Andamans. There are flights from Bangalore, Chennai, Calcutta, and I think Cochin also, I'm not very sure, but definitely from Chennai, Bangalore and Calcutta. I traveled from Bangalore. Go Air was the operator. It took around 2.5 hours, and I had done the booking almost 3 months before my travel date. So I got a price something like 12,000 rupees for my return fare. So if you book your ticket in advance, it would be good. All the flights land at Veer Savarkar Airport in Port Blair. That's the capital of Andaman. So that's how you reach Andaman. You need to stay in Port Blair at least for 1 day before you decide as per your travel plans. Planning your travel inside Andaman. So let me make it very clear. You need to have a very good local tour operator if you want to efficiently utilize the time. Otherwise, you will be having trouble reaching different islands, especially because of the transportation. So what I did was, I had contacted a tour operator, one of the best tour operator in Andaman, and my experience, I would give a say 4.5 out of 5. It was good experience for me, except one or two times when they got bit late, not too late also, that's acceptable. So Experience Andamans is a very reputed tour operating company in Andaman, so you can contact them. I will leave a link in the description. I am no way connected with this agency. I am suggesting this because I used them and it was good for me. So what I had done was, I had given them a list of places I wanted to visit and the duration of my travel. So they arranged all those things as per my time and my requirement, and they sent me a plan which I went through and I approved it, and they gave me a quote for that. So that was how I planned my internal travel in Andamans. Now let me clear one confusion. Many people I see in the internet and many forum, they mention about Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Definitely we have Andaman and Nicobar Islands, but Nicobar Islands is not where we can go. It's only for the tribals. No public is allowed to enter. There are some government officials staying there and the local tribals. Nobody is allowed to get into Nicobar Island. So let's make it very clear. And other important thing about Andaman, Andaman consists of around 570 islands. Out of that, 30 plus are inhabited. You can plan your vacation in a way so that you can cover the best islands nearby, or depending upon your time. Time is very important. I had around 10 days. I could go almost till the northern part of Andaman. So about planning your internal travel, the best thing would be to have a tour operator, local tour operator. Don't go for any Thomas Cook or big tour operators, because they would be connecting with local small tour operators to help you out. So best thing would be somebody like Experience Andamans. Connect with them and give them your plans, and they will even suggest you. If there is something wrong in your plans, they will correct you and give you the best plan, and once it's confirmed, you can go ahead with that. So that's how we plan the internal movement in Andamans. Now, places to visit in Andaman. Once you land in Port Blair, you can spend 1 or 2 days in Port Blair. You can see the Silla Jail, which is very famous. That's how we know Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Silla Jail. Then there are some beaches, especially the Corbin Cove Beach in Port Blair. There's an aquarium. There is a museum, a tribal museum, which is really good. We saw few places in Port Blair. Then what we did was we traveled to Havelock. Havelock is a very good island and a lot of tourists go there. You have to travel around 2.5 hours from Port Blair. And you have to book a ticket in advance. Again, all these things were arranged by our tour operator because we don't know when to book, what is the timing, all those things. So the cruise was booked by our tour operator. It took around 2.5 hours. The ride was beautiful and pleasant. We reached Havelock. A hotel was booked very near to the ferry terminal. The hotel name was Havis. Please check my videos, okay? I have given very detailed videos of all the days at Andaman. It would be really helpful for you. So we stayed at Havis. In Havelock, basically you would be going to few beaches. Other than that, Havelock, there is a really good beach called Elephant Beach. Now, Elephant Beach is the place where you go for snorkeling and sea walk. Now, if you are interested in water sports and you want to do snorkeling and sea walk, let me share my experience about snorkeling and sea walk. What was told to us was when we took a ticket of say 800 rupees, I think, for that, which includes a transfer from the Havelock island to Elephant Beach. It's a 20 minutes boat ride. They take you there and they told that you will get a 5 minutes of snorkeling complimentary. So when we reached there, they took us to just maybe say 20 meters from the beach, and it was very shallow water, and they just showed us this is how snow. And if you want to really do snorkeling, you have to buy a ticket for 800 rupees, and they will give you a video also. Basically, that was I felt that, and they told that it would be around 10 to 20 minutes. Hardly they do for 5 to 6 minutes, they'll just take you around. But it was okay. I will not complain about that. It was okay, but it was not the way it was explained clearly. And I was a bit upset about the sea walk thing. Sea walk, for per person, they charge 3,500 rupees. It was a mess to get in the queue. It was too crowded. Almost 2 hours we had to wait to get our turn. And when I reached, from the beach, they will take you to the place where the sea walk is done. It's bit, say, around 100 meters from the beach, where a big ship sort of thing is set up. You get into the ship and there they will give you a basic training. And you go down, I think, deep, I don't know exactly, maybe 10 meters or 15 meters down with the oxygen helmet sort of thing worn. They charge 3,500. And I had carried my GoPro camera there, and I wanted to take some video. They told no, you cannot do that. So, and you have to pay another 700 rupees to get the video, which I felt was a bit of cheating, and it was not worth also. 700 rupees for a video, or maybe hardly, they took us down for 10 minutes, less than 10 minutes. We were told that it would be around 20 minutes, but it was less than 10 minutes, and there was nothing more to do for more than 10 minutes also. So what they advertised and what they gave was a bit different, and I don't know whether 3,500 was worth it or not, but anyway, we enjoyed it. So if you are interested, you can go to Elephant Beach in Havelock for these two things, the snorkeling and the seabed walk. Then the beaches are good, and it's a day trip. Morning you go and you come back before sunset. You will feel that it's a different island. Actually, it's Havelock. It's the same island, but you go covering some jungle and all, and you reach there in 20 minutes. So that was a good thing. Other thing what I found in Havelock was it was a costly island, and Havelock is being developed as a tourist hub. We stayed in a hotel called Havis. And when two, three of us have our lunch, it was costing more than 3,000 to 4,000 rupees, which was very surprising for me. And the charges are quite high. The food was very costly. So that's one important thing which you need to know about Havelock. Port Blair, I don't think it was too, but overall, Andaman trip, we spend a lot of money for food. To be very frank, maybe we were quite choosy. We went to restaurants which were quite okay, but it was not any five-star restaurants or anything. So I would compare that the cost of the food was like a five-star cost. That's a very important thing that which you need to keep in mind. So after Havelock, we came back to Port Blair because our next plan was to travel to Diglipur. Diglipur is a place where you can go to Rosensmith Island, which is the northern part of Andaman. And to travel to Diglipur, you need to give at least 16 hours of road trip. To be very frank, we started around 3 a.m. We reached a place where a convoy starts. It's a secure 45 kilometers of drive where police escorts all the vehicle. It goes through a protected area of where the Jarawa tribes are living. So there vehicles are not allowed to stop and overtake a vehicle. Lots of rules are there, but all these things are taken care by the taxi drivers or all these. You don't have to worry about all those things. So we started from Port Blair, reached Diglipur in the night. On the way, we saw limestone cave. Limestone cave is good. It's in a place called Barathang. When you travel from Port Blair to Diglipur, there are two places where your vehicle gets into the Jangar and it's the river or the mangrove is crossed. It's an interesting thing. You will really enjoy it. So we saw the limestone cave. Then we went to Wayar, Rangat, Barathang, and then finally we reached Diglipur. And we stayed in Diglipur that night, had dinner and all. So the next day in Diglipur, we went to the Aerial Bay ferry terminal jetty. It's called Aerial Bay jetty, where you go there, buy the tickets. And because we had organized through a tour operator, we never had to go to show our ID cards to get the tickets or stand in queue. All those things were fully arranged. So from Aerial Bay jetty, we went to Rosensmith Island. To be very frank, I wanted to see the Rosensmith Island. I had seen some videos. It was amazing. So I thought we'll go there. And believe me, it was amazing. Rosensmith are twin islands connected by a sand, a sand bridge. When the tides goes high, the islands get separated. And when the tides go low, you can walk between these islands. It's a beautiful island. Can spend almost 3 to 4 hours there. You can have swim, all those things, nothing else. And you have to carry food and all those stuffs when you go to Rosensmith Island. And Rose Island, there are some good birds and all those things are there. If you are interested in that, you can spend some time. But they will give you only 3 hours. That's the way how the tour is operated there. So that's a good place to visit. And after Rosensmith Island, the next day we returned back to Rangat. We stayed in Rangat and then we visited a place where there is a mud volcano. It was actually, I didn't know how it would be and all those things, but for me it was like a bit upsetting because it was very small volcano and all. It's being promoted like for ecotourism and all those things, but don't go with big expectation because it was on our way. We saw that it was good. Then there was a mangrove walk on the way in Rangat, Barathang, that area. And same way, like we stayed one day in Rangat so that the 16 hours journey was broken down. And the next day morning from Rangat, we traveled back to Port Blair. In Diglipur, other than Rosa and Smith Island, there are some other things like the Alfred Caves, the tortoise nesting, and some few things are there which we didn't have time because we had to return to Port Blair. If you're planning to stay in Rangat, there are no much choice of hotel. We stayed in a hotel called Rose and Smith Hotel, and it was okay. When you travel from Diglipur to Rangat, ask your driver to stop at the Austin Bridge in Mayabandar. It's a beautiful bridge where you can see the river, and if it's a sunset time or a sunrise time, you will really have some good pictures. I was lucky to get some sunset pictures and all. Then there is one beach called Amkunj Beach, not so great, but if you want to get down, Amkunj Beach is there. So to conclude the places to visit in Andaman, I would say there are many beaches. There are some historical places in Port Blair. There are some scenic beauty and beautiful place actually. More than like going to see something, while you travel the length and breadth of Andaman, you will really love the nature, the scenic beauty, the mangroves, the forest, and all those things. That's really important. That's what I really liked. The beaches are excellent. Same like Maldives beaches, I could see the same. The difference between Maldives and Andaman was the forest. Thick forest we could see in Andaman, and in Maldives we don't have the forest. That's the conclusion on places to visit in Andaman. Now, some very important things that you should know before you travel to Andaman. First thing is connectivity. As soon as you reach Andaman, buy a BSNL SIM. You may be having a BSNL connection, but the data packages don't work there. So you have to buy a local BSNL SIM. If you have an Aadhaar card, it gets activated within 1 or 2 hours. Airtel, Vodafone, all those things, no, it won't work. No, I didn't even get, I was having an Airtel connection. My data didn't work even in Port Blair. So forget about different islands. So BSNL was the only connection which could work in different islands, and that too, data doesn't work well. Internet connectivity is a serious problem. If you are a person who needs to be connected all the time to your office or business, then it's going to be a serious problem for you. Even most of the hotels in these remote islands don't have good internet connectivity. They may give you a Wi-Fi, something like that, which would be working at very low speed. You won't be even able to download your mails and all those things. So be prepared for getting cut off from the internet. That's very important thing you need to note. So the best time to travel to Andaman would be between October and March. The climate would be good. You won't be burning too much in the hot sun. Being a video blogger, I wanted to fly drones, but I had tough time to fly drones. It was very difficult. Police were there all the places, and they were stopping. They were not allowing to fly drones. So you have to take some risk to fly drones if you want, because there are a lot of military installations there, military, navy, all those things are there. So you have to be very careful before you fly your drone. And from December 1st onwards, the new drone policy is going to be implemented. I don't know how things are going to work. So drone, be very careful. Then carry cash. Digital India is still not active in Andaman. So you have to carry cash. And ATMs are there, but you may not find it like you find it in your city. So possibly take some, at least 50% of the cash that you would be planning to spend in Andaman. Carry a good SPF 70 sunscreen lotion, or you may get sunburns, because when you go to beaches, it's really sunny, so you have to be careful. If you have some problems with ultraviolet rays, be careful, consult your doctor about this, and take care of yourself. I'll put a link on a very good SPF sunscreen lotion which I used. It was good for me. Use sunglasses, protect your eyes, and if you are a photographer, carry a ND filter, it would be good. I was using a ND filter so that I could take really good pictures. I'll put a link of the Tiffin ND filter which I use. It's a really good ND filter. You can check that also if you want to buy. Locals, communicating with locals, it's easy. Most of them know Hindi, so it was not a problem for me. And to be very honest, locals are really tourist friendly. They take care of the rules and regulations. They will explain you all the rules and regulations so that you are safe. And I am very surprised that they are really promoting tourism. They are really taking care of the tourists. They respect the tourists. So very good thing. People of Andamans, a big thumbs up for you people. So that's all. I shared my experience. I've done a lot of videos about the places I explained. You can have a look at those videos. I am putting the link of the playlist of, I think, 8 to 9 videos which I made short. So you can see, have a look and feel of the place. Believe me, it's a must visit destination. You should not miss it. So plan your trip to Andaman. Enjoy. There are no tourism in Nicobar Islands. Don't get confused. you will be going only to Andaman Islands. That's all for now. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please share, subscribe, and comment. Bye for now.